No, I did say it was, like, difficult to...
I know what you're doing. It's fine. And I don't care. I'm here to make friends with anybody. Anybody that doesn't want to make friends with me, I'm super down for that, too. But I'm down to be friends with you, B. I'm down. I'd love to get to know you, but you can't just walk in here and start up some stuff like that on my first day when I'm just minding my own business, you know?
Okay, well, you know, I apologize if that's how it's come across. It wasn't meant to, genuinely. And Noreen's been, like, one of my closest friends in the house. We spent loads of time...
You can't be a bad person if you're Noreen's closest friend. I'd like to be your friend, too. And I apologize if I came off as... There we go. Pow. That easy.
AM. Some of the housemates are in the living room. Siavash has been in the diary room for the last 45 minutes.
Are you feeling okay to return to the house now?
I do. I'm just gonna go and sleep in the sitting room. I'm gonna go and accidentally fall asleep. To be honest with you, hopefully we'll feel better tomorrow and stuff. The only thing that it's difficult. I don't know, people don't understand me. Like, it's maybe because the country I'm from, maybe the way I was brought up, some things to me are very, very hard. And sleeping in the same room for me is very, very, very hard. I just physically cannot be in the same room. So you'll probably see me sitting in the living room and whistling as Marcus does to early hours, and then trying to get some sneaky sleep.
Was there anything else you'd like to talk to Big Brother about?
No, honestly, I'm fine.
You're welcome to come to the diary room anytime you like.
Thank you, I do appreciate it, guys.
Have a good night's rest.
Thank you.
The door is open.
Oh, the fuck?
So, rock and roll. Rock on. Wanna go hang out? So rock and roll that I very rarely roach. Even if I'm late for that shit, I ain't going to roach.
Noreen is in the bathroom.
That's fine. Do you have actually upset?
Well, I'm gonna talk to Sierra about it. I don't think it's anyone else's business.
Yeah. Yeah, but if he's not our business, you shouldn't keep telling us you like him, blah, blah, blah.
The thing is that you can like someone and you can love someone. There's a difference. I never said I love Siraj. What's wrong with you?
No, I don't have anything to do with your life, like you said.
You're obviously upset with me because you think I shouldn't like my ex-boyfriend.
Mm-mm. You can't help your feelings. You like or you don't like, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
And you're a different person than me. But it was with me and I was with someone in the house. I would say to the person, but at the moment I'm with this person, you know, not just jump from one person to the other person. I imagine if it was with me, I would feel devastated. Wouldn't you? I know you're not doing it because you want his marriage. You know you're doing because you...
I'm not going out with anybody. I was never going out with anybody. I'm single. I'm 25 years old.
Yeah.
I'm single.
Yeah.
I still love my ex-boyfriend.
Yeah,
exactly. I'm lonely in this house. I kiss Sierra because I like Sierra. I fancy Sierra.
Yeah.
But
I
love my boyfriend. My ex-boyfriend. I love Isaac.
Yeah.
Whatever happens, happens.
Yeah. 2:21 AM. Some of the housemates are in the bedroom talking about Isaac. Isaac and Noreen are in the living room talking about Siavash.
You should really go talk to him.
Why?
Because I was, like, kissing him. I slept in the same bed as him last night. That's bad, like.
But if he's got the problem, and you don't. I don't
understand. But, like, everyone in this house is like, Maureen's such a bitch for doing that.
You remember that time that I told you I don't give a fuck?
Yeah.
Yeah, that still applies.
Yes, let's just have fun.
Marcus and Siavash are in the sitting room.
If you get through this and then carry on and end up having a good time in here again, you could leave like a fucking man. It is definitely a chance to shine.
Well, to be honest with you, there was just said to Big Brother, if this is my moment, I definitely do not own this fucking moment. I was happy with not having any fucking moments. And everyone did say sort of like, be careful. I sort of was convinced.
You know what I think about Noreen? I think that she only moved things on with you because of B.
Yeah.
She had all this time to do it, and as soon as B started talking about your arse and flirting and stuff like that, I think Noreen wanted to put her nose in front. Just make sure that all the boys liked her, because I said, she came up to me the other day and we were sitting by the pool. Mm. And I said, why are you even talking to me? Why are you wasting your time? And she went, I don't know, tell me. And I said, it's because you've got to have everyone liking you, and you can't stand it if people don't want to know you. And she went, oh, well, if that's what you think. And it's like, well, tell me that it isn't then. And she didn't say fuck all.
Can't fucking wait till Friday. See what happens on Friday.
Would you want to go then?
I really, really want you to stay, because if you go right now, it will be, like, really bad. I know I should say that I really want Noreen to go. But I just think that she's a confused little girl. I don't know what the fuck she wants. I don't know what the fuck she's doing. And if she leaves, I would feel guilty.
four oh eight a.m. Marcus and Siavash are in the living room.
Well, I hope this is the last of the bad month, because bad month has been very, very bad. Fucking, it's been a bad fucking month. No food, no nothing.
Just remember to keep it in your Big Brother brain. Keep it all in your Big Brother brain.
Yeah. This is not how it was meant to be. This was not the plan. And you think, like, if you've done things differently, how things would have been very different. Should have just kept the fuck away.
The rest of the housemates are in the bedroom.
The lock on this bitch. Sleepy Marcus.
See you tomorrow.
Who the fuck are you kidding? Oh, thank you guys. Nice and warm. It's very kind of you.
Marcus and Noreen face the public vote. Who goes? You decide.